So may I show you some designs, some special designs of the Austrian Mint? So these are one of the first Schillings, the produced after the Second World War. My favorite design is a 10 shilling coins from Mr. Welz. You see the drawing. The drawing is the lines are perfect. He's a really good artist. He knows what he's doing, because you see the design is exactly the same on the Plaster model, and it's a very, very beautiful coin. Everything is on the place where it should be.
Now she's wearing a traditional headgear from Wachau.
Yeah, it's named Wachau. Wachau is a region in Lower Austria. And yeah, this is a very traditional, what is the name for it? It's typical for this region. And yeah, this is a reverse, the first reverse. This coin was a silver coin in the first time, and afterwards changed. It will be a nickel coin, and the reverse was the eagle. After the war, we started to produce our own coins, not the Deutsche, for the Deutsche Mark. We started to produce the Schilling once again.
And so this design was very important for sort of the reestablishment of like the Austrian national identity after the war.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, coins are always a part of identity for a nation. And so the Schilling was also very important because we had the Schilling before 1938. And it's definitely a part of identification. Also after 1918 we start with the Schilling. Later on, after the First World War, and then the Schilling was the national currency until 2002.
So obviously in 2002 you switched away from the Schilling to the Euro, but what was the purchasing power of a 10 shilling coin when it was still made out of silver?
Wow, what could you buy? So two packages of chewing gum or so. Yeah, a chewing gum costs one piece, one shilling. So 10 chewing gums costs 10 shillings. Maybe a bread or so, 1 kilogram of bread max. Maximum. So this is 10 shilling.
So tell me a little bit about the artist.
Mr. Welz, he worked here in the Austrian Mint also for a few years. He was the like the chief engraver. And afterwards he was at the university, and he was teaching how to produce a coin and also a medal. And you find a lot of reliefs around Vienna or in Vienna, big, massive reliefs, which he produced in the university, for example, Kennedy also, near the Vienna Stephansdom.
Oh yeah, I've seen that.
Have you seen that? Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's very famous. He knows a lot about how to do a portrait. Most of his portraits is done in profile. And he knows very important are the eyes and the mouth and the nose. Right. And you don't need so much details.
Yeah, the 100
the cheek. So he focused on the eyes and on the mouth. And he was also able to do the drawing. He see a person and he did it directly on his paper. And afterwards he started to modeling and sculpting this portrait in plaster.
Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Well, thanks for sharing that with me.
You're welcome.